Hey guys, thanks for tuning in to another video on ForgottenWeapons.com. I'm Ian McCollum, and I am out here at the range today with a South African 37mm Stopper, appropriately named. This was designed by a guy named Andries Peek, who has shown up. He was involved in several other domestic South African arms production projects in the 1970s and 1980s. And the origin of this actually, well, it's for the South African Police Service, and they had, of course, they had 37mm riot control guns for less lethal, you know, rubber bullet sort of things, tear gas, that type of application. And they had actually been using grenade or tear gas launchers made by federal labs in the United States that dated all the way back to the 1930s. Well, by the 1980s, the international embargo on South Africa prevented the South African police from being able to get parts and do standard routine maintenance on their federal labs' guns. So they needed some replacement firearm that could take, well, take that thing's place. So they turned to Andries Peek, and in 1980, he sat down, took 2 weeks, and developed this guy. There are only two different versions of this. There's this one with two pistol grips, and there's a version that doesn't have the front grip. So pretty much a one-and-done sort of design, but it's simple, and it works. We have a folding stock. There's a little latch right here in the front that allows you to collapse the stock. There's a big latch on the side, which if you are shooting this right-handed, would fall right under your thumb. That pops the barrel open, load around, close it, manually cock the hammer, and fire away. So these were adopted by the South African police in 1980. They were manufactured from 82 all the way until 1999, and they're still in pretty common use today. So we're gonna try shooting some stuff. We're gonna start with a couple of flashbangs and then try some rubber baton rounds. There's the shell. Bloop. Is it supposed to do that? All right, we need to change the camera so that people can see that. All right, we got to do that again. So this is like a crowd control bird bomb, and the different shells have different designated detonating ranges. So how long, there's a little timed delay in this between when you fire it and when it actually goes kaploop. This one is set for 70 meters. So that berm is a little less than 70 meters, which means this is going to hit, delay a moment, and then detonate. And bounce up into the trees. This is really cool stuff. There is no extractor or ejector. There's just cutouts on the side, so you pull the case out by hand. This thing is super freaking cool. These little rounds have literally no recoil. They feel almost like firing blanks because they are just meant to basically frighten and intimidate people. When I say this detonates, it's like almost like a firecracker. It doesn't produce, obviously doesn't produce shrapnel. It's just there to make a bang in or above a crowd and get people to just disperse. So let's do another one. I don't think we've been able to see either of the previous two detonations yet. Hopefully this one we have a wide enough angle that you will. Sometimes it hits the backstop and ricochets. There it goes. Well, that one went off. We may have some UXO on the shooting range here. There it is. Woo! There we go. So, cart 37mm, cartridge 37mm, aerial sonic, so it's just a bang. This is a 70-meter one. And then here we have the same thing, different color coding. That's 140-meter. So this is the we're playing nice with the crowd ammunition. And if that doesn't make you go away, then they break out the real stuff, Riot Irritant 37mm CS tear gas, and 37mm baton. This is a gigantic rubber bullet. And I have heard, allegedly, some of the guys would load baton rounds and then drop D-cell batteries down the front of the launchers as well for extra persuasive power. Those exploding airburst firecrackers were pretty cool. Now we're going to try the more serious thing. We have a baton round here, and we have our human dummy who is, he's refused the order to disperse, probably because he has no legs, but that's not my problem. Hopefully this won't bounce back and hit me. That hit him. You know, I was expecting the recoil from these to be pretty severe. I've done a little bit of shooting with some 37mm bean bags. Those things kind of kicked. This is really not that bad. So that rubber bullet baton thing is this guy. And I really quite honestly don't want to get hit by one of these. So, that said, as long as you're on the shooting end, this thing's really fantastically fun to shoot. So a big thank you to my host who made this all possible. Hopefully you guys enjoyed watching, and tune in again tomorrow for more Forgotten Weapons.